Buenas noches, NCLR. Buenas noches, mi gente. All right. Thank you for that very warm welcome. The Ruben Salazar Award for Communication is named in honor of a journalist whose newspaper stories and newscast reports during the turbulent 1960s placed the then emerging Latino community at the front of American media. As a reporter for the Los Angeles Times, Ruben Salazar traveled the world as a foreign correspondent, reporting on the Vietnam War and political turmoil in Latin America and Mexico. It is his diligence in reporting his own home turf about the unfair treatment of the Los Angeles Hispanic community that made Salazar his greatest contribution. In 1970, Latinos around the country gathered in East Los Angeles to protest the disproportionate number of Chicanos killed in the Vietnam War. Over 20,000 supporters from around the country peacefully marched throughout the city until a scuffle with police turned into mayhem and madness. Ruben was covering the event for a Spanish language television station. At the end of the day, he stepped into a local cafe so he can rest. Within minutes, an LA County Sheriff's tear gas projectile was fired through the cafe's doorway, killing Ruben Salazar. However, his words and his work live on every day for journalists who search for truth and create the opportunity for every voice to be heard. His legacy lives on with the NCLR Ruben Salazar Award for Communication. Each year, NCLR presents this award to an individual who has dedicated his or her life to promoting accurate portrayal of Hispanic political, economic, and cultural contributions to American society. Tonight, that honor is bestowed upon a person who not only stands for social change and justice, but the betterment of the Latino community, and also acts on it. NCLR is proud to award this year's Ruben Salazar Award for Communications to journalist and publisher Rosana Rosado. What makes Rosana Rosado so important to our community is that she just doesn't report the news, she lives it. Like Ruben Salazar, her professional life is intertwined with the community she serves. As one of the most prominent voices for Latino New Yorkers, Rosana is an outspoken and active participant, a combination that resonates with her newspaper audience. She takes to heart journalism is more than just reporting what happens. It is an opportunity to advocate for her readers. She practices civic journalism, believing that journalism and readers are participants in the political process and social process, not just spectators. As a participant, journalists and newspapers must go beyond reporting the news. She'll make sure that her newspaper covers voter registration and then hold a voter registration drive at her newspaper's office. Let's take a look at the screen behind me for the who, what, when, why, and when of this year's NCLR Ruben Salazar Award for Communications honoree, Rosana Rosado.
She's been a phenomenal caretaker of a very important institution for the Latino community in New York, but for all New Yorkers. And she's protected it, she's nurtured it, she's made it grow, she's made it adapt to the time. So she's been just a phenomenal steward of a very, very key institution that turns 100 in a year.
She brings this profound understanding. She just has a nose for journalism, for finances, for trends, and seeing beyond. And I think that really stems from her sincere commitment, and that level of commitment becomes a magnet for success. She has plenty to show for how El Diario has succeeded, and I think that this 100th anniversary is really gonna be a statement not only about El Diario, but about Rosana Rosado's leadership.
You know, The great thing about Rosanna is that when you have a conversation with her, whatever the subject is, she still finds a way during that same conversation to help you connect to another person or to another challenge that needs attention. She swings conversations towards issues and people that need addressing. Constantly moving, constantly thinking.
Passionate, engaged, and fiercely committed to her readers. Those words both describe El Diario and its publisher, Rosanna Rosado. As the oldest Latino newspaper in New York City, El Diario has earned a loyal audience among the city's more than 2 million Hispanics. Whether it's improving education, protecting the right to vote, or helping to get the first Latina and first Puerto Rican on the Supreme Court, Rosanna has made sure that she not only informs and educates her readers, but also serves as a strong and courageous voice for those who too often have been voiceless.
She's championed equity and justice through her newspaper all day, every day. That's what she does. That's how she brings it. That's what she brings to every room she enters. That's what she brings to every conversation. She is driven by the fact that no one should be left behind. Really, no one should be left behind.
We work with women and men being released from prison. And Rosanna's instrumental in trying to help in any way she can. What she's done is got people into professional internships. So she's called in all her friends from government, from city, from, you know, local community people and said, will you provide an intern for this person? And most of those interns led to jobs. Rosanna cares about, you know, the biblical principle talks about the least of thee, you know. She seeks out the least of thee in everyone. And that's where she belongs. That's where she wants to be.
I can't think of anybody more deserving than Rosanna. This is an award that goes to people that have demonstrated a lifetime of commitment, that understand the power of storytelling and media, and the way that we communicate shapes the way people think about us. And she has been at the forefront. She's dedicated her entire life. She is the embodiment of the Rubén Salazar Award.
Señoras y señores, please give a big, warm, insular welcome to the 2012 Rubén Salazar Award for Communications from New York, New York, Rosanna Rosado. There she is, I'm sorry.
Thank you. I am truly humbled by this honor before such an amazing audience. Being around all of you for the last few days has been invigorating. I want to thank you, NCLR, and especially Janet Murguia for your leadership. I am moved by your tribute to me. Watching the video made me want to meet Rosanna Rosado. But like the TV ad for a cell phone network, I have this incredible team behind me that you can't see, that's not here with me tonight. They are the staff at El Diario in New York, at La Opinión in Los Angeles, and of Imprint Media products all over the country. They are second and third generation Latinos whose careers are a testament to their parents, their grandparents, and to our heritage. To those people who came to this land so that today I could be publisher, so that they could have these great careers in corporate America. They are journalists from all of our countries focused on improving the lives of Latinos here in this country. When I explained recently to a colleague that NCLR brought together all of the nonprofits in the country, all the nonprofit leaders, he quipped, So since you're a newspaper exec, are you considered a nonprofit leader? He's a good friend. Otherwise, no se atrevería, but for the record, El Diario has been a profitable paper for the 17 years that I have been in charge. And I am proud to say that we are taking that brand to its 100th anniversary. And like Jesse James Leija, don't I look good for 100? La Opinión is also a profitable business in its 86th year. But here's the thing. Receiving the Ruben Salazar Award reminds me that you don't run news brands like El Diario for profit. You run them in service to a community. You run them to fill a void for people whose voices might not otherwise be heard. You run them with a commitment to take up causes, to write editorials, to apply pressure, and to influence others into serving your audience. You run them to effect change. These are all the values that have made journalism a noble profession. And in that way, we share an alliance with the leaders of our nonprofits, of our community organizations, which are represented here tonight. So I want to take this opportunity to remind you also to support us, your newspapers, your media. I know we're in the iPad generation, and some of you are tweeting right now. I know the folks at my table are tweeting. I'm on Twitter too, at Ro Rosado, but I'm still asking you tonight to go out of your way, to get out of your car in LA, and to walk another block in New York, and to buy the paper. I know, it's old school. Thank you. I know it's old school, but you know, we're Latinos, we have a tradition of having one foot in the old world and one foot in the new. And we must not forget or diminish the power of an endorsement from our Spanish language newspapers. I also want to take a moment tonight to salute the NCLR for your decision to have an LGBT track this year. That's an applause. I am the parent of a gay teen who's on her way to college this fall. The only thing that has ever worried me about her or for her is her safety or the idea that someone could judge her or hurt her because she is gay. The well-attended workshops here this weekend are the right signal that the whole issue has to come out of that secret space where it has resided in our families. In New York, El Diario's support of the gay marriage bill led a local state senator, who is also a reverend, to call for a boycott of the paper. And I'm happy to tell you that the impact of that boycott was that dozens of white gay men from different parts of the country called to subscribe to El Diario. Even though they could not read the paper, they did not want the boycott to hurt us. We have always seen gay rights as basic civil and human rights. One of the first weddings after the marriage bill passed in New York was in my backyard last August for a couple who had been together for 37 years. One of my grooms, who would pass away 8 weeks later, made a toast that day, and he thanked all who attended for bringing our children. They are so fortunate, he said, to witness love in all its forms at such a young age. They will make this a more accepting world. I take to heart the Bible quote that to whom much is given, much is required. And it has truly been my blessing to spend my career in service of our people and indeed of our nation. Thank you.